Welcome to the Ohio Bureau of Workers' Compensation Division of Safety and Hygiene's micro-training series. This session focuses on answering common questions about safety data sheets in the workplace.
What is an SDS, or safety data sheet?
Safety data sheets are documents that include information about the properties of a chemical, hazards, protective measures, and handling, storing, and transporting a chemical. Until 2012, these sheets were called MSDSs, or Material Safety Data Sheets. But material was dropped when the standard was updated.
Are safety data sheets standardized?
All safety data sheets must be prepared according to Section G of OSHA's Hazard Communication Standard. There are specific guidelines on how hazards should be classified, and OSHA details which sections must be included in an SDS. When looking at any SDS, the section titles and order should always be the same.
What are the sections of an SDS?
A safety data sheet has 16 required sections. They are all important for different reasons, but Section 1 is a good starting point. Here, you'll find the identifier, which is the chemical name, and its recommended uses, as well as the manufacturer's information. Section 4 features important first aid measures to administer in the event of an overexposure. If you will personally handle the chemical, Section 8 covers the necessary personal protection measures and equipment. OSHA Brief 3514 can help train you on the SDS sections. It's also important to find out who you should go to in your company if you have any questions about the SDS.
Do I need to have an SDS for all chemicals in the workplace?
The Hazard Communication Standard only applies to hazardous chemicals. You might not be aware, however, that more chemicals have recently been designated hazardous, including those that merely cause skin irritation. A good rule of thumb is, if the shipped container has a pictogram on it, it is a hazardous chemical.
Is an SDS only required for liquids?
No. There are hazardous gases and solids, so they would have an SDS as well.
Do I need to keep SDSs for commercial products like window cleaner or correction fluid?
The OSHA Hazard Communication Standard does not extend to household products unless they are used more than a consumer would foreseeably use the product. If window cleaner, for example, is used to clean a single bathroom mirror once a week, this is a typical consumer use. Regulations would not apply, and no SDS would be required. However, if an employee cleans glass panes at the end of an assembly line prior to shipping, the exposure is higher than the average consumer would face, and the SDS would need to be available to employees.
Are there SDSs for water and air?
You can find SDSs for water and other common items, but they are not required unless there is a chemical hazard identified.
Where should SDSs be kept?
SDSs must be kept in the workplace and should be easily accessible during work hours for all employees. Often, they are kept in binders at a work site. SDSs may be stored electronically if employees have no barriers to viewing them. That means employees must have unrestricted access to where SDSs are stored and know how to find them.
What happens if we don't have an SDS?
There should be a written company policy that outlines what to do with chemicals that are received without an SDS. Without this information, the chemical should not be allowed into the workplace. A common solution is to have a quarantine area in the shipping department where chemicals are placed until the manufacturer sends the information.
Where does an SDS come from?
There is no SDS, Stork. The company that makes the hazardous substance is responsible for creating and updating an SDS. If you are a product manufacturer, we recommend you refer to OSHA's website for guidance on the SDS's 16-section format and hazard classification determination.
If we have a question about a chemical, what should we do?
If you have a question about a chemical or any part of a safety data sheet, contact your supervisor or safety person. Your written hazard communication program should also detail who to go to for questions. This overview about safety data sheets in a hazard communication program is not meant to be all-inclusive, only a supplement to your company's specific training. If you have further questions, visit our website at bwc.ohio.gov. Click Search. Type in Safety Consultants and press Enter. Thank you for making safety a top priority.